Hello everybody. You know that at Villa Monica Farm we want tails to occupy a very special place, and that's why we use tails for many activities. Our school has been implementing one new or innovative teaching method, that is learning project learning based. And they have made a project based on tails. We have done also some other activities related to tails, and Marisa López Soria, who is a writer from Murcia, came to school to present her tales and her stories for young people, to all of you. Also, Pilar Duke came to tell the students stories, and we had the visit of Alan Kennedy from Scotland, who is a storyteller as well. And today we are very lucky because we have one of your classmates, Carmen, who is going to tell you this tale, My Dad is a Clown. It's a very special tale because it talks about many important values nowadays, such as tolerance towards sexual, different sexual orientations, and diversity within the families. Nowadays we have different kinds of families, not only the traditional one, and all of them they should be respected, and tolerance in general. So please give an applause to Carmen.
Okay, hello, welcome. My name is Carmen, and I'm going to tell you a special story. The story is called My Dad is a Clown. This is Dionisio, a classmate who is going to help me with this story. Okay. One day, a classmate walked out with him, and he decided to call him Clown. But the children was very happy about him, and he kissed him. The classmate couldn't understand it, but it's because his father is a clown. He is very fortunate because he has one of the most important jobs in the world, because he makes people laugh. But this time has two fathers, and he's very happy about it. His other father is called Pascual, and he is a doctor. Pascual says that they have the two most important jobs, because one heals the body and the other heals the soul. Every morning, Pascual wants to get up his dad, but he never could do it. They always end up laughing because it's fun to listen to them. The child doesn't know what he wants to be when he grows up, but he would like to be a spy, because for him it's interesting to spy everything. One morning, Pascual and the boy decided to spy him at the other. And he followed him at the other and hid behind the seat without being seen to spy on him. The boy was flabbergasted to see his father do this, but he thinks that rehearsals were very tough and hard. Now he understands what really wants to be a clown. Having such wonderful father made him laugh and cry with joy. He is too happy to have a father who is a clown, but he is more fortunate to have such a wonderful father. Today, he has decided what he wants to be when he grows up, and he wants to be a doctor with a bright red clown's nose.
Una síntesis en español muy rapidita para la gente que no tengamos el nivel. Hazlo con los dibujos ya puestos, una síntesis en español. ¿Vale? Venga.
Bueno, pues el libro de Mi padre es un payaso es muy interesante porque, aunque es un libro para niños, en realidad tiene valores muy importantes, como las parejas homosexuales, por ejemplo, porque hoy en día aún no está todavía bien visto y hay personas que no aceptan eso. Entonces, yo creo que este cuento está muy bien para ir enseñándoselo a los niños e inculcándoles valores que son muy importantes en la vida. Bueno, pues así rápidamente, un compañero estaba enfadado con él y decidió decirle payaso, pero él se lo tomó muy bien porque su padre es un payaso y está muy orgulloso de ello, porque él hace a la gente reír. Y cuando un día decide ir a espiarlo con su otro padre, se da cuenta de que ser payaso no es tan fácil como todo el mundo lo ve, que detrás de eso hay muchos ensayos y que también son muy duros. Y él es muy feliz porque tiene otro padre, que es médico, y según él, tienen los dos trabajos más importantes del mundo, porque uno cura el cuerpo y el otro cura el corazón. Él es muy feliz con sus padres y él al principio quería ser detective, pero tras ver la importancia de esos trabajos, decide que quiere ser un médico con una nariz de payaso, porque le gustaría hacer feliz a la gente a la vez que la cura.